To celebrate Black Friday for today, this particular Friday, I am going to the Bricky merch store and making every single thing in the merch store 20% off, with the exception of our brand new merch item, the mug, the bee mug. You want this adorable pink bearded bear sipping on this mug? You want him on that mug? Do you want that mug and then have a sticker, another sticker that comes with that mug with the same image? You can go ahead and check out BrickyMerch.com if you want to pick that guy up. That and all the other 20% off stuff for the rest of the store if you use code BLACKFRIDAY in checkout. Enjoy. Well, what a wonderful thick and fog day to you, survivor whose muffled screams creep out everybody and anybody. My name is Bricky, and welcome to the Dead by Daylight case file featuring the Demogorgon, or better known as the Screechy Boy. Demogorgon's lore is present in the very popular Netflix original show Stranger Things, and this should obviously be a spoiler section, just a heads up. A feral predator, Demogorgon is similar to a wild animal that hunts its prey for food, fun, or fertilization, at least as far as we know. It comes from the Upside Down, or also known as the Vale of Shadows, depending on how you want to say it, I guess. A dimension that parallels our own, but filled with death and decay. The Demogorgon's home. Its motivation and intelligence are not very specific and don't need to be. It's smarter than the average animal, but its goals are exactly the same: hunt and kill. Stat-wise, the Demogorgon has 115% movement speed with a 32-meter tear radius. He has normal lunge range for his standard attack, as well as normal break speed and vault speeds for his kit as well. The Demogorgon's power is a two-parter. The first part is of the abyss. The Demogorgon can place down portals wherever it pleases. These portals can then be traveled between each other with a mild cooldown. These portals will not be shown to a survivor until they have been used at least once, also known as activating them, and survivors can destroy these portals as well once they are activated. However, this requires a long action time, and during that time they are afflicted with the oblivious status effect. The Demogorgon also has a second power called Shred. By holding down the right mouse button, you can charge up for a leaping attack, slowing your movement speed shortly. You need to charge for roughly half a second to a second, with the longer charge sending you farther forward. If you hit a survivor, you damage them, but do not afflict on hit attacks like normal basic attacks do, i.e. exposed status effects, save the best for last, etc. If you hit any type of wall, you get stunned for a short period, and if you hit a pallet, you will destroy it immediately. Also, when you prepare your charge and shred ability, survivors near active portals will be shown via the killer instinct ability so long as that portal is still alive. So, power out of the way, how do you play Demi Lovato? Well, Demi is a wonderful addition to the cast. He's probably my favorite killer at this point, and for multiple reasons. I know I feel like I'm swapping my favorite killer a lot between Dr. Spirit, now Demi, but Demi is really, really fun. Now, the first reason I like him so much is his presence. Demi is pretty terrifying when fighting, because every time he's on the map, he's just always spooking someone. Whether it be the screech he makes when he hits a survivor that almost everyone on the map can hear, or the screech when he teleports, showing everyone he has teleported, but nobody knowing where he is, and the loud as hell footsteps he makes when he comes up to you and causes you pain, Demi is legitimately scary and I love it. As for gameplay, he has a lot going for him. He has map pressure through his portal abilities, and he can do really well in the chase thanks to Shred. Being able to traverse fast and also end chases quickly are the two most important parts of being a killer. Demi does this really well, yet I find myself struggling with him very often. It's weird. Demi is very good. He's really, really good, I'd say. But I always feel like I should be performing better with him than I am. I don't know if I'm the only one, and if you feel the same way too, please let me know, because it drives me nuts. But whenever I'm playing Demi, I feel like I struggle way harder than I should with a killer this good. I end chases quickly, I have good portals, and I travel well, yet I have such a tough time. Then I played Survivor for a while and started fighting more Demis and began to understand. He has a ton going for him, but he has a few problems that I can totally see slipping under the nose of people. For instance, The presence that makes him so damn scary is also a good way to show survivors they aren't in danger. So long as Demi is screeching, you know you're not in trouble as long as you're not the one he's attacking. You can find out he's chasing somebody way earlier than being notified by a damaged survivor in the corner, because you can hear him going for hits and going for shred attacks. And you also feel like you shouldn't go help the person he's chasing, because shred is so easy to whip around on survivors, and it also discourages altruism, which makes you want to do gens faster. Also, whenever Demi teleports, we all know he has a cooldown for it. So if you hook and then teleport, which in a sense is what you should be doing all the time because you need that map pressure, then they immediately know he's not by the hook anymore. So it makes extremely easy saves, and also it's easy to clean up portals because the moment he teleports, you know he can't go to the portal you're currently working on. Also, Shred is really good ability, but even with Shred, you'll find yourself eating a lot of pallets. A lot of times, survivors will drop pallets early because they know you're going to Shred into it, and that actually will extend chases a lot more often because you'll very rarely get hits through pallets like most other killers will. Any of those cheeky hit through pallet stuff just doesn't really happen on Demi, and it's pretty annoying because you end up eating a lot more pallets per chase. Now, does this help you in the late game because all the pallets are gone? It does. But there are still lots of issues with things like windows that you still have to deal with. Also, he needs to set up his portals. Considering he only has a couple portals each, you have to really find the right spots to place all of them. But this wastes a lot of your time setting up everywhere you need to go, and that early game is so crucial. All in all, it's bizarre. Demi is very good and has great abilities, but these abilities all have a weirdly adverse effect on him. Just simple things like not knowing where a killer is, no matter how small, can make a big deal in the game. For instance, Freddy can teleport to generators and such at a whim, and nobody knows he has done that teleportation besides those that are at that generator. The fact that the entire map knows Demogorgon is moving around is great for a thematic purpose, because Demogorgon's got a great theme to him, but it's bad for a gameplay purpose. Shred is really scary and forces pallet drops, but therefore you're gonna be eating a lot of pallets because of it. Everything that makes him good is also kind of giving him a few problems as well. So let me tell you a few ways I can try and fix and mitigate this issue. First things first, the double portal. One of the things I like to do is carry a survivor to a hook that's somewhere near where a portal already is. Then you place a portal right next to the hook and teleport to the other one. This will make the Claudette, who is definitely crouching right behind you, go for the hook because she thinks you're far, far away. And then in reality, you can just pop around the corner with your undetectable status effect and whack them down. Oh crap, that's right. I forgot to mention, you get an undetectable status effect when coming out of your portal. Whoopsie. Well, that's a thing, but trust me, it's not that useful. The downside to this double portal strat is that you need two of your limited supply portals, so it's pretty risky. Secondly, Shred is like Melee Huntress. When activated, survivors will start running left or right in an attempt to dodge it. A lot of times you can discourage enemies from taking a certain route by charging it up and then letting it go, baiting them into taking the long way. For instance, if the God Pallet's already dead and they're running for the window in the shack, you can charge it to make them not go for the window, and then you can easily get a hit off because, well, they've ruined their own loop. Also, Shred's power is very helpful for setting up portals in important areas. Portals by gens are great as lets you know if a survivor is near and can help save you a lot of time. The downside is having all these portals out and about like that makes it very likely to be destroyed. Any Demi player worth their salt knows that it's generally good to always have one or two portals in your stock for quick situations. Like if you hook a survivor, see barbecue and chili, they're going for an exit gate or another hook save, slap that portal down, immediately make your way over to the one you already have prepared. It's great to have like a little pocket portal for situations like that. If you're not gonna place your portal next to a gen, put it in an area where someone would run if they hear someone making their way via the portal system. So if there's a jungle gym by the gen, slap it there, because when you teleport over, they'll run towards you instead, and that's the one few time where the undetectable status effect can be very useful because you can get a nice jump on them and really cause them problems. Finally, your mechanical skill with Shred will take some practice. Knowing exactly how far you can dash is a big deal. Take time to learn it and see exactly how far you can go if you want to stop that loop. All in all, Demi is great, but his greatness can be the detriment. He's the physical manifestation of DJ Khaled suffering from success. Still a ton of fun though. On the fun meter? huge. So let's talk about Demi's teachables. AoE kicks, locked in here with me, and the sprint burst nerfs. Surge is a okay anti-gen perk. It saves you time from having to go kick gens and throws a bit of extra progression loss your way. Thing is, it only works with a basic attack down, so not shred. Has to be a normal hit, which is a bit against Demogorgon, but still okay for others. Surge is fine, just isn't as good as the other gen perks. Not bad, just outclassed. Cruel Limits is great when it works, and it only works when a gen is completed. And if you want that stuff cut off, that means this perk is only useful exactly when you arrive when a gen is complete. It's very situational. If the time frame for it to work was longer, maybe 45 seconds or a minute, it might see more play. But until then, it's a strong perk that works very well 1% of the time. Finally, Mindbreaker is great for one type of killer, those that spook people on gens. If you're on a gen and a Wraith or a Ghostface shows up, it's gonna be pretty good if you're using any of the exhaustion perks. Sprint Burst will be gone, and Lithe or Balanced landing opportunities will also disappear so long as they're sprinting away from you the entire time. That can be really helpful, but since the exhaustion only works 4 seconds after getting off the gem, it feels like it's only useful for stealth killers going for surprise attacks, not Demi who's screeching every half second. For good Demi perks, anything with solid tracking. Barbecue, Thrilling Tremors, Bitter Murmur, and Rancor are all really good. I especially like Rancor. Knowing where survivors are can help plan your attacks better and make it easier to find people. Discordance is also amazing too, but I feel like that's a given. Pop Goes the Weasel is probably one of his best perks as well because of his ability to get to gens quickly after a hook. And for a side perk, Bamboozle can actually be pretty useful. If you block off a window, you really lower a survivor's escape choices and generally funnel them into a single section, which makes Shred far more deadly. For Demogorgon meme builds, I like maximum Demi presence. Distressing, Unnerving, Clown Phobia, Infectious Fright. You do get a ton of good stuff by using a big terror radius with Infectious Fright. Finally, we have Demi's Mori, serious gourmet shit. So in conclusion, Demi is a great killer that struggles from his own greatness. Everything that makes him good makes him have a tough time at high ranks, but honestly, I don't know if I would change him. I think the only buff I'd give to him is making it so he emerges from his portal a little bit faster, and maybe allowing you to see where survivors are even if your portal isn't activated yet. Because if you wanted to get a drop on them, well, you still have to take the portal and therefore activate it. I think that would be very, very useful for him. I want people to run the risk of me eating their ass when they're destroying a portal as well, so popping out of it faster could be really useful too. Anyway, thank you very much for watching the Demogorgon case file. Please do check out the Black Friday sale and the awesome new mug that you have seen on the screen almost this entire case file as well. I just love it. It's so cute. It's so damn cute. Also, the Oni case file should come out about a week or two after his release on live servers if you're curious. My name has been Bricky, and treat Demi nice. He's a good boy. Bye-bye.